look you in the eyes, and I'm gonna tell you the future. You were cut from your high school basketball team. You willed your way to the NBA. You're gonna win championships. It's an American story, and that's why Americans are gonna love it. People are gonna build you up. God, are they going to? Because when you're great and new, we love you. Man, we'll build you into something that doesn't even exist. You're gonna change the fucking world. But you know what? Once they've built you as high as they possibly can, they're gonna tear you back down. It's the most predictable pattern. We build you into something that doesn't exist, and that means you have to try to be that thing. All day, every day. That's how it works. And we do it again, and again, and again. And I'm gonna tell you the truth. You're gonna be attacked, betrayed, exposed, and humiliated. And you'll survive that. A lot of people can climb that mountain. It's the way down that breaks them. Because that's the moment when you are truly alone. And what will you do then? Can you summon the will to fight on through all the pain and rise again? Who are you, Michael? That will be the defining question of your life. And I think you already know the answer. And that's why we're all here. A shoe is just a shoe. Until somebody steps into it, then it has meaning. The rest of us just want a chance to touch that greatness. And we need you in these shoes, not so you have meaning in your life, but so that we have meaning in ours. Everyone at this table will be forgotten as soon as our time here is up. Except for you. You're gonna be remembered forever, because some things are eternal. You're Michael Jordan, and your story is gonna make us want to fly.
So what, you're blaming me?
I'm the one frustrating
you. It's not about who's who's blaming who, or who's frustrating who. The frustration is there, and we're both dealing with it, you see. Me personally, I refuse to rot inside, so I find solutions. And at this point, sex was just a question of personal hygiene.
Yes, but you impose your solutions, which are solutions for you only. You don't give a shit if it hurts me and Daniel.
You leave Daniel out of the game here. This is not about Daniel. I do not impose anything on Daniel. You made us live here among the goats. You complain about the life that you chose. You are not a victim. Not at all. Your generosity conceals something dirtier and meaner. You're incapable of facing your ambitions, and you resent me for it, but I'm not the one who put you where you are. I've nothing to do with it. You're not sacrificing yourself, as you say. You choose to sit on the sidelines because you're afraid. Because your pride makes your head explode before you can even come up with the little gem of an idea. And now you wake up and you're 40 and you need someone to blame. And you're the one to blame. You're petrified by your own fucking standards. And your fear of failure. This is the truth.
It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful. And so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary. But somehow, we're always doing it wrong. Like, you have to be thin, but not too thin. And you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but also you have to be thin. You have to have money, but you can't ask for money, because that's crass. You have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to lead, but you can't squash other people's ideas. You're supposed to love being a mother, but don't talk about your kids all the damn time. You have to be a career woman, but also always be looking out for other people. You have to answer for men's bad behavior, which is insane, but if you point that out, you're accused of complaining. You're supposed to stay pretty for men, but not so pretty that you tempt them too much or that you threaten other women, because you're supposed to be a part of the sisterhood, but always stand out and always be grateful. But never forget that the system is rigged, so find a way to acknowledge that, but also always be grateful. You have to never get old. Never be rude. Never show off. Never be selfish. Never fall down. Never fail. Never show fear. Never get out of line. It's too hard. It's too contradictory. And nobody gives you a medal or says thank you. And it turns out, in fact, that not only are you doing everything wrong, but also everything is your fault. I'm just so tired of watching myself and every single other woman tie herself into knots so that people will like us. And if all of that is also true for a doll, just representing a woman.
The world is changing. Truth is vanishing. War is coming.
It's been a long time, Fran. You've no idea the power I represent. It knows your story and how it ends.
Listen to me. The world's coming after you.
His fate is written. Shall we write yours too?
If anything happens to them, there's no place that I won't go to kill you. That is written.
Hello, ma'am. Would you like a cocktail to start?
Oh, no, I'll just take a cup of tea.
Oh, come on, have a cocktail.
No, a cup of tea is fine. I've eaten already.
And you, gentlemen, did you save room for dessert?
Yeah, what's that?
That's our signature dessert, Cherry's Jubilee.
Sounds great. Bring the young vandal here, Cherry's Jubilee.
I'm afraid I can't. The dish contains brandy. Same deal with the Bananas Foster.
Yeah, but doesn't the alcohol just burn off? Mm.
It's still against the rules, ma'am.
Fine. I'll order the Cherry Jubilee. We can share it.
I can't allow that either.
Can we say it's his birthday?
It's my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday, young man. Well, let's get you a slice of cake or some other age-appropriate dessert.
Christ on a crutch. What kind of a fascist hash foundry are you running here?
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you by chance have cherries?
Yes.
Great. And do you have ice cream?
Yes.
Fantastic. Can we please get cherries and ice cream to go?
And the check.
Right away.
Bitch.
And little James Beam. All right. Oh! Presto, Cherry's Jubilee.
Ooh. Shouldn't it just go out?
Shit.
How much alcohol did you put on there?
It's very
odd. Sire moves us to the new world. We're gonna need names. I mean, 89Q12, it's not really a name. So, I would like my name to be Lila.
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 That's a pretty name, Lila.
Thank you.
I think my name shall be Teefs. Because although we all do have them, mine are definitely the most prominent.
Teefs.
Lila.
Teefs.
Me'd be called Floor because me is lying on floor.
You're lying on a floor, so your name is Floor?
Yes.
Floor.
What about you, friend?
Someday, I'm going to make great machines that fly. And me and my friends are gonna go flying together into the forever and beautiful sky. Lila and Teefs and Floor and me. Rocket.
Rocket.
It really is good to have friends. Yeah.
Saying hello.
You think your wife can hear you?
No.
Then why bother?
Maybe I'm wrong.
You're going to die.
Maybe not.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend.
A new day is dawning. New ideas, new rules, new management.
We've known each other since we were 9 or 10.
Who is this?
The Marquis de Grammont.
Challenge him to single combat.
Win or lose, it's a way out.
I don't sit at the table.
Your family does.
Please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family.
Man has to look his best when it's time to get married. Or buried.
I'm going to need a gun.
Goodbye, my friend. It's hard to die.
If you win, the table will honor its word. You'll have your freedom.
Under the old laws, only one can survive. Failure to meet at sunrise will result in execution.
There's a word in Korean. Inyan. It means providence or fate. But it's specifically about relationships between people. I think it comes from Buddhism and reincarnation. It's an inyan. If two strangers even walk by each other in the street and their clothes accidentally brush, because it means there must have been something between them in their past lives.
보고 싶었어.
나도.
If two people get married, they say it's because there have been 8,000 layers of inyan over 8,000 lifetimes.
I was just thinking about what a good story this is.
The story of Hesong and me?
Yeah. I just can't compete. It's just that you make my life so much bigger. And I'm wondering if I do the same thing for you.
You were right.
I was?
He came here to see me.
You never sleep talking English. You only dream in Korean. You dream in a language that I can't understand. It's like there's this whole place inside of you where I can't go.
Stahe are murdering us. In the case of Anna Brown, her family here on the west side have raised funds with an amount of about $2,000 to $5,000 for the arrest and conviction of the murderer. Molly Burkhart has hired a private investigator.
Hi.
When this money started coming, we should have known it came with something else, because it's white man's money.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's not what we were taught coming down Missouri, mm-hmm. Arkansas, and Kansas. Yeah. What has come to our reservation that doesn't belong here, and it's them. Mm-hmm. They're like buzzards circling our people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gonna pick us body clean, leave nothing.
Mr. Wonka?
Yes?
What's going on here?
Oh, my goodness.
That's impossible. Unless... Yeti sweat?
Yeti sweat.
The most powerful hair potion in the world. I didn't put it in there.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please! There appears to be a manufacturing error! Nobody eat the flowers!
Why not?
What's wrong with them?
What's the matter with this toadstool? My daughter took one bite and just look at her!
There's nothing wrong with the chocolate milk.
Is there?
I'm terribly sorry, everyone, and I don't know how to explain this, but... It appears that the chocolates have been poisoned!
Poisoned?
What's poisoned?
You poisoned my child!
I didn't poison them!
I want my money back!
I want compensation!
I want revenge!
One summer weekend, Henry drove down from London to the countryside to stay with Sir William W. The house was magnificent, so were the grounds. But when Henry arrived that Saturday, it was already pelting with rain. The host and his other guests whiled away the afternoon playing games, while Henry glumly stared out at the drops splashing against the windows.
Henry wandered out of the drawing room and into the front hall. He drifted through the house, aimless, then finally mooched into the library. Sir William's father had been an important book collector, and all four walls of this huge room were lined with beautiful, antiquated, leather-bound volumes, floor to ceiling. Henry Sugar wasn't interested. The only books he read were detective novels and thrillers. Nothing like that here. He was about to leave when his eye was caught and held by something quite different.
There's been an official complaint.
Oh, I see. You brought me here for an intervention. Or to slap my wrist. That's not why I'm here. You think if I could be shot of this debt, I wouldn't be? You think if I could just go through the usual channels, I wouldn't? That is not how this debt works. It demands a result, not an appeasement. There is a hook in me. One that you cannot see. But it is there.
Place is gorgeous, Hal! It's like a dream!
Once you've met someone, you never really forget them.
Like this for anything in the world.
By day, he worked as a programmer for the government at the Soviet Computer Science Center. But by night, he invented games for fun. His computer, a Stone Age Soviet piece of crap called an Electronica 60, didn't even have a graphics card. His falling blocks were parentheses pushed together. Alexei and a couple of buddies from work made the game IBM compatible, which meant color graphics, 8-bit music, and floppy disks that people copied and shared for free. It spread like wildfire. But this is the Soviet Union, remember? Nothing gets out easy.
I was big. I was bigger than bubblegum. I woke up and I noticed my pinky. Auto-animated. Parkinson's disease. I told Tracy the news. In sickness and in health, I remember her whispering. No one outside of my family knew. There was only one reason I took these pills, to hide. But all those years of hiding was shaking me awake.
These two are fighting and ideas are banging around in Bella's head and heart like lights in a storm.
Oh. You're always reading now, Bella. You're losing some of your adorable hips peeking.
I'm a changeable feast, as are all of we. Apparently, according to Emerson, disagreed with by Harry.
Come, just come.
You were in my son.
What?
Why do you want to play me?
When they sent me the script, I just thought... Now, here is a woman with a lot more to her than I remember from the tabloids and our cultural memory.
I don't really think about all that.
You don't ever dwell on the past?
I have my plate pretty full.
Don't go.
This was a mistake.
No, no, it isn't. Trust me. I know how hard it is to get here. It's damn near impossible, and you did it. Don't run away now because of me.
There are thousands of meetings. I'll find another one.
Wow, yeah, but this one has the best snacks.
I want to go.
No, no, no. You've made it this far, and I wouldn't.
I don't want to be here.
Nobody does in the beginning.
I don't want to be anywhere.
Then you are definitely in the right spot.
Detonator charged.
We're in a race against the Nazis. And I know what it means. If the Nazis have a bomb.
We have a 12-month head start.
18.
How could you possibly know that?
We've got one hope. All America's industrial might and scientific innovation connected here. A secret laboratory. Keep everyone there until it's dark.
Let's go recruit some scientists.
Build a town, build it fast. We don't let scientists bring their families, we'll never get the best.
Why would we go to the middle of nowhere for who knows how long?
Why? Why? How about because this is the most important thing to ever happen in the history of the world?
You're the great improviser, but this... you can't do in your head.
Are we saying there's a chance that when we push that button, we destroy the world?
Chances are near zero.
Near zero.
What do you want from theory alone?
Zero would be nice.